This video is going to be all about roof windows. So first, I'm going to be talking about what are roof windows and what are all of the components that need to come together to complete a high quality functioning roof window. Then we're going to be tying everything in with Revit, with VELUX BIM, where I'm going to be showing you how to download some free, high quality, highly parametric Revit families that also have quite a reasonable file size. And then I'm going to be showing you how to get all necessary project documentation for those windows. Let's go. This video is a collaboration with VELUX, and I'm going to include all of the links for everything that they mention down in the description of this video and then also up in the cards above. So if you want to check it out, you can easily find it there. And full disclosure, this is a sponsored video. Now let's start with what is a roof window. Well, roof window is both a roof and a window in one singular element. To make a roof window, we need to combine multiple elements. We're going to start with clash, the outer finish of the window that connects the roof covering tiles, slates, or metal panels. Then we're going to have the underfelt color. This connects to the roof felt. After that, we have the actual window with a pre-built metal cover as external finish. We're also including an insulation color to interrupt the thermal bridges between the window frame and the roof bearing construction. We also want to include a vapor barrier color, interior lining, and there is a system solution for external thermal protection, light control on the inner side, and insect screen that is mounted on the inner plane of the ceiling. Now, for all of the windows that VELUX offers, they have all of the standardized dimensions, so you can find a perfect fit for any possible situation. And now, let's check out some of those high-quality Revit families, and for that, we have to go to BIM object. So here we are at the BIM object page for VELUX roof windows. And if you want to check this out, I'm going to be leaving a link to that up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. So here I'm just going to scroll down this page a little bit and then you can see we have this video and I would like to encourage you to check this video out. It really explains the whole approach of VELUX towards sustainability. It's a really interesting project and it really explains kind of their whole mission, and I think it's a noble cause, so it's something worth taking a look at. Now, if I scroll past that, you can see here we have our roof windows. So if I go to view all products, you can see we have a very large variety of windows and products, and you can pick out any one that you like for your project. In this case, I have already kind of selected this window which I want to use, so I'm just going to here hit download. And then you can pick out all of the files that are going to be downloaded. So I'm just going to deselect all and I want to just get Revit and also really important, get the Revit family type catalog. And I'm going to be explaining the importance of this in a minute. So now I'm just going to download that selection. And now when I open up the folder, this is what we have. So we have the roof window family, and we have the type catalog. Now to properly use the family and the type catalog in Revit, what you want to do is not just dragging the family over, but you want to go here to Windows, then you want to go to load family, and now you need to find it on your computer. And here's that folder. Now it's not going to show the type catalog, and that's okay. It's important just to pick out the family, and just because the type catalog is in the same location, it's going to pull that data. And now, once I hit open, it's going to open up that type catalog, and this is what that looks like. So it might look intimidating, but all of these are the family types, so the versions of this window which you can get. Now, luckily, we have some filters, so instead of loading all of these in, you can just pick out the ones that you need for your project. So now let's find the filter for height, so not the rough height. I'm looking for just the regular height, so that should be here. Okay, height. And then here I can open that up and I'm just going to set it to this height. So it's now filtered out all of the windows that don't have that height. Now I can move to width, and the width should be here somewhere. Let's see, here's the width. So for the width, I'm going to filter down to 780. Now moving forward, let's take a look at the exterior cover material. So that's over here. And for that, I'm just going to pick out aluminum dark gray. Moving forward, let's take a look at frame and sash material. And here I'm just going to set that to pine wood white painted. And then I'm just going to adjust the glazing material as well. And here I'm going to go with the triple glazed material. And now we only have one window filtered out and we can only now load in that particular window. I'm going to click OK. It's going to convert it or upgrade it to the latest version of Revit, which I'm using. And now I can start placing it in the model. So here I'm just going to place a few of them on my roof. So you can see these families are highly detailed, and of course we have a lot of parametric adjustments for them. So if you select the family, first you want to make sure you make some crucial adjustments in the beginning. So first you want to define the current roof slope. So basically you can take a look at your roof. So you select the roof and then you go down to slope and you can just click there, Control C to copy, and you can go back to the window and here you can go Control V to paste, hit apply, and now it has that correct roof slope parameter. Now this, when you select a family, all of the parameters that appear here in the properties panel are instance parameters, and all of the parameters that are here in the edit type are type parameters. That means that these parameters will affect all of the instances that are that we have placed here in the model, but these parameters here will only impact the one selected instance, or if we have selected multiple instances, then multiple ones, but only the ones that are selected. So in this case, even though I've adjusted the slope for this window here to 36.87, this one still has the old slope. So I would select these two windows here and then I would paste in the same slope just to make sure we have everything set up correctly. Next, you also want to set up the thickness of roof material. Now, this is also really important for the positioning of the window along the depth of the roof. So let me explain how that works. Here, you have this called thickness of roof material. So roof material is basically the roof cover. If I select this roof, go into edit type and then go to structure and click on edit, we can see that the thickness here is 6 millimeters for this thickness. So I can adjust the thickness of roof cover for all three of these windows or roof material to 6 and then hit apply. So now it's going to have kind of the correct position in terms of depth on that roof. Now you can see this if I create a section perhaps, or okay, I already have a section, so I can just use that. And then if we zoom in here and I'm going to turn on the thin lines, you can see here, this is that roof material or the roof cover material, the finish material. So it's located over here and we have these two dots, the red dot and the blue dot. So this should basically the kind of the bottom of that roof material or the finish roof material should be at least at the red dot, or it can go up to the blue dot if you want to have a recessed installation. In this case, I'm just going to leave it at this, and then I've selected, I think, all three, so all three have this parameter adjusted. You will see that the window has some additional parameters which you can play around with, and also if I go into edit type here, we do have some additional parameters which we can change here. Now, really important, make sure you don't really change the dimensions, so the width, the height of the window, or even the material, just because when you change this, it's not going to correspond to the product any longer. So if I make this window bigger, so if I make it like 1,000 millimeters, I can do that, and being a type parameter, it will change all three windows. However, if you contact Velux later and say, okay, I want this window in 1,000 millimeters, well, they might not have it at that dimension. They might have it at, I don't know, 1,010 millimeters, and then you have to change the plans just because you've made that manual change with the family instead of searching for the correct family in the type catalog, which is something that I would definitely recommend you do. Now I'm going to be showing you how to compile the rest of the project documentation that you need, but before that I want to show you the VELUX daylight simulator or daylight visualizer. This is an amazing software which allows you to basically export an OBJ file from Revit and then run these high quality, really precise daylight simulations. So if this is something that you're interested in, you might want to check it out. Now let's go back here and let's produce now our project documentation. So I'm going to be leaving a link to this page up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. Now here, let's go to our profiled tiles in this case for this particular project. This is going to be just a core product. It's going to be a standard single window. This is going to be a GGL. And then it's a three layer glazing as we have set it up. And then for the window placement, as I've mentioned, in this case, I have placed it at the red level. So I'm just going to select that. And this is for our flushing setting. And now here we have the product and we can preview that. So as you can see, this is what we're going to get for our project documentation. So all of the detailing, everything that you need, it's just there. And then you can use it in the project. And here we have the download button so you can get it a Revit file, a DWG file, or a PDF file, so you can download any one of those that you might need. Now, I would just like to show you what this looks like kind of in a project. So here we have a roof plan. Well, this is just the roof construction with the openings left for the windows. Then here we have a roof plan with the roof cover. And then this is all of the additional information that we have. So all of the details, everything for this particular roof plan, all of the schedules and so on and so forth. So this is what this would look like kind of in a real life project. And I think it illustrates the importance of having all of this project information, the details, and all of that. Finally, I would just like to show you some of the kind of windows that got my attention from the VELUX window library. So basically here we have just a kind of a regular window, but then we have this window that's kind of at the intersection of a roof and the wall. So I think it looks really, really cool. And it's actually not that difficult to set up in Revit. Then we have this roof balcony, which kind of opens up and you have the kind of the little railing here. And I really like this one. I think it's so impressive. And then finally we have this, which is kind of a light tunnel. And let me show you this in the section. So here, if I open up, it should be here. Okay, here we go. So here it's it basically takes sunlight from the roof and then it can get it down through the ceiling, and you basically have a light, which is not a light, it's just transporting light from the roof down to your living room. So I think this is really cool. It's actually out of two families and then you just assemble it. But again, it's just a kind of an impressive window technology, I guess you can say. And that's going to conclude this tutorial. I hope you have enjoyed it, and I'll be back with another Balkan architect tutorial soon. Bye.